It's spring here in Raleigh. The trees are waking up from what has been a long winter, and they're not the only things waking up. We're also seeing insects and disease beginning to emerge. So today, let's talk about the things you need to know to keep your trees safe. I'm Basil, I'm a treecologist here at Leaf and Limb. And when it comes to identifying pest issues, the first thing you've got to do is inspect the tree. You're looking for anything that's outside of the ordinary. Let's start at the top of the tree with the leaves. What are things you can see that could indicate issues? Look for the color of the leaf. Is it the color it should be? If there's discoloration, that could be a sign of an issue. Are the tree leaves damaged? Is there chewing activity happening? Are they falling off? Are they growing irregularly? Do they look like they should look? Do we see insects covering the branches? Or are the branches colors they shouldn't be? For example, crepe myrtles typically have a tan or cinnamon colored bark. If that bark is black, could be a problem. Or with a maple tree, is the maple a silver gray color? Or is it a black color? That could indicate several different issues. How about the trunk? Does the trunk look healthy? Are there splits or cracks or holes or material oozing out? Are you seeing anything that looks odd? Excessive amount of sap coming out of a particular hole? Down towards the bottom of the trunk, are you seeing mushrooms growing? That can be a sign of decay. Do you see the bottom of the trunk? Or are you seeing mulch or dirt piled on top? So those are just a few of the things you can look for. Again, the goal is you've got to identify what is normal and what is not normal. To do that, you've got to spend some time with your tree. You've got to build a relationship with that tree throughout the year. See how does it look in March versus October? What is normal in July versus January? Establishing that baseline will make the inspection all that much easier. As you begin building that baseline with a specific plant, you are going to notice problems. You're going to see insects, you're going to see disease, and that's okay. Don't worry about some insects or disease. It's a very normal part of our ecosystem. I mean, after all, they are part of that plant's living ecosystem. What we're looking for is too much of that particular insect or too much of that particular disease. This is something we call threshold. And when the insect or disease surpasses a certain threshold, it does take a toll on the plant's health. When treating for pests, you've got to be very specific in how you do so. The goal is to disrupt the life cycle of that specific organism without causing any unintended harm to other members of the ecosystem. Otherwise, you might end with a problem much bigger than the one you started with. Another very effective way to treat pests is to identify the underlying health issue and fix that. Because if you can do that, you'll create a healthy tree that's able to naturally defend itself from these pests by keeping a balanced ecosystem. At the end of the day, the goal is not to eradicate the pest, but rather it's to restore balance to an ecosystem. And we do that by creating a healthy tree. My name is Aninga Montoya. I'm a treecologist here at Leaf and Limb. Can we use that one today? When treating for a pest, I'll just spit. I can't get it. I just keep blacking out. What is it? What is the line?
You might have a problem that's much bigger than the one you started with.
That you started with. Oh, my lands. Let's do this again. Oh, my lands. Then what you started with. Started with.